Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where the team of flight controllers is watching over the activities of the three-person crew aboard the International Space Station. Today, Jerry Jason is the flight director in charge of the team, and Mark Reagan is the spacecraft communicator. He'll be talking with the crew as needed to coordinate activities aboard the space station. Of course, Expedition 35 is the expedition this period, and that is made up of Commander Chris Hadfield, the first Canadian commander of the International Space Station. NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn, a physician spending 4.5 months on orbit, and Roman Romanenko, Russian Federal Space Agency cosmonaut, making his second trip to the space station. Today is mostly focused on the upcoming departure of the Dragon spacecraft, which is going to be carrying important scientific samples back to Earth for analysis. The crew today did some last of its early packing activities, and will be putting the final research samples into the SpaceX Dragon cargo vehicle on Sunday before the hatches are closed. Dragon will be unberthed from the Harmony module, a common berthing mechanism port it's attached to on Monday. The start of operations has been adjusted a little bit earlier. Preparations will begin now at 3:20 a.m. Central Time on Monday, with the unberthing beginning at 4:05 a.m. and release expected about 6:49 a.m. Central Time. Splashdown off the coast of Baja California is expected about 20 minutes after noon Central Time on Monday. NASA TV's live coverage of Dragon spacecraft departure begins at 4 a.m. Central Time Monday. Chris Hadfield started his morning by performing a water sample analysis using the Total Organic Carbon Analyzer, or TOCA as it's called in NASA nomenclature. Later on, he removed the sample processing unit from the coarsening in solid-liquid mixtures experiment and downloaded some of the data from that experiment. That's one of the experiments that was carried up on Dragon 3 weeks ago, and it will be returned to scientists at Northwestern University near Chicago just days after it left the station. That's very important to them as they want to analyze those samples as quickly as possible since they tend to degrade if left in storage. Hadfield also worked with the binary colloidal alloy test, which examines very, very tiny particles that are spread throughout liquid. That's known as colloid suspension and commonly found in things such as milk, paint, and electric polishing compounds and food products. Tom Marshburn, meanwhile, is continuing checkout activities of the Marangoni inside experiment. Marangoni convection is the flow that is driven by the presence of a surface tension gradient that is produced by temperature differences within the liquid-gas interface. Convection in liquid silicon oil is generated by heating one disk hotter than the other disk in this experiment, and scientists are trying to observe flow patterns of how the fluids move to learn more about how heat is transferred in microgravity. The experiment is a Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency-sponsored experiment. Marshburn's been working in the Destiny Laboratory on that experiment all week long. Marshburn also working in the Columbus Laboratory today to prepare for the first run of the seedling growth experiment that's inside the European Space Agency lab. That experiment looks at how plants grow in space. We'll be taking images of the plants and downlinking them to Earth throughout their growth period. And then the plants are going to be harvested and returned to Earth for analysis by the scientists with that experiment. Results of that research may be able to help researchers improve food production on the ground, and that could also help with food productions for future long-duration missions to other destinations in our solar system, such as asteroids, Lagrange points, the Moon, or Mars. A little bit later on today, Marshburn and Hadfield will continue their transfer operations for the Dragon cargo craft. They will also complete some onboard training in preparation for Monday's departure of the cargo vehicle. Marshburn and Hadfield will be at the controls of Canadarm2 for the unberthing and release of Dragon. Roman Romanenko today is working on some preventive maintenance in the Zvezda service module. He's also replacing one of the shutoff valves for the water storage tanks in the Russian section of the station. Space Station mission managers are in the midst of a meeting to review Dragon departure preparations. We expect a go, no-go decision from that meeting a little bit later on this morning. Overnight, Mission Control Moscow directed a slight increase to the space station's orbital altitude. That's to adjust phasing for the arrival of three more crew members for Expedition 35. Pavel Vinogradov, Alexander Masurkin, and NASA's Chris Cassidy are scheduled to launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan at 3:43 p.m. Central Time next Thursday. They'll be docking with the space station about 6 hours later in the first single-orbit rendezvous for humans. Tested that capability on Progress unmanned vehicles previously, but never on humans. The launch coverage will begin at 2:30 p.m. Central Time, March 28. The launch again scheduled for 3:43 p.m. Docking coverage will begin on NASA TV at 8:45 p.m. with the docking set for 9:32 p.m. And then at 10:30 p.m., NASA TV will begin coverage for the Soyuz hatch opening and welcoming ceremonies. That hatch opening is scheduled for 11:10 p.m. on Thursday, Central Time. Today, that trio is on the ground at the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. On the left in this crew portrait is Chris Cassidy, in the middle, Pavel Vinogradov, and on the right, Alexander Masurkin. Three crew members are making final preparations for launch. All systems on the International Space Station continuing to work very well today. This is Mission Control Houston.